The project I have created this time is a pixel clock. As you may remember, I made a pixelator with ESP32 S3 with a 1.3-inch display and a camera module attached. I personally found it very interesting. It simply converted the image from the camera module into larger pixels and drew them on the screen. Anyway, it was fun. After my last pixelator project, I became more interested in pixelating. So this time, I made a clock made of big pixels. How does it look? It's very, very simple clock. The timer starts running once every second, turning the column in the middle on and off. And if it is time that the time digits need to be updated, the appropriate digit is drawn again. That's it. Let's talk about drawing the screen in more detail. I used LVGL to configure this screen. Since LVGL allows for various screen configurations, I was able to develop as I wanted. If possible, I'd like to try an actual project using Slint, but it seems like I still need more time. Back to the project, the first thing I thought about was how many tiles I should make. This is because the grid that needs to be drawn on the screen will change depending on this. To make it as simple as possible, I made each digit a 3x5 tile. To put detail into numbers, we need to allow for much more data to be entered, but I decided on a 3x5 size to make it simple. I figured that if I drew a 19x9 grid, I would be able to include all the information I wanted, since I needed to draw 2 digits for the hour, 2 digits for the minute, and a column in the middle. This is how I drew the screen. If you look at the digit font file, they will all have 3x5 data. If there is a color, it is 1, otherwise it is 0. I also created a blank font for the blanking column, so I could easily have the column turn on and off every second. For more details, please check the source code in this project's GitHub repository. I thought it was too boring just to have the time information, so I added a snake game for fun. A snake randomly appears on the screen and moves around looking for an apple. The snake finds an apple on the screen, eats it, and then disappears. Actually, the snake game we are thinking of is that after eating the apple, the tail should grow longer, but then the screen would be covered with the snake, the tail instead of the clock, so I didn't add that on purpose. Again, this is a clock. The last feature I didn't mention is the tile touch. Each tile is created because of the 19x9 grid. The reason it displays the time and allows the snake to move around is that each tile can change the color. That means it's an independent object and you can even include touch events in it. When the tile is pressed, I made it so that a random color tile from the selected tile falls down. I think it's not that bad. I press it every time I feel bored. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.